Hachette Audio presents Barnstorming Ohio, To Understand America. Written and read by David Giffels. For Evan and Leah. With any luck, you'll find a rainbow purged of sullen promises. Elton Glazer, Drowning in Ohio. Build it like we own it. Plant motto, GM Lordstown Assembly. Chapter 1, A Funhouse Mirror. The pre-dawn moon poured its cold white shine through the kitchen window and across a countertop spread with 24 freshly frosted Ohio-shaped cookies. The lights were still off, but I could see the cutouts, lined up from the night before, pale blue with navy piping, in rows on waxed paper. The coffee dripped one last time, then the beep, beep, beep of the machine. Ready. First Monday in March, 2019. By day's end, those cookies would be decimated by a wide-eyed pack of fourth graders. My 23-year-old son would walk through the back door wearing an Akron police uniform for the first time. The GM Lordstown auto plant just up I-76 would be tooled for its demise, and Luke Perry would be dead. A farmer down in Delaware County was loading corn to market, preparing for a trip later that day to Virginia, where he would talk to legislators at an agriculture conference, all the while worrying about the prospect of another wet spring. After months of speculation, one Ohio politician was preparing to announce that he would not run for the Democratic presidential nomination, while another was preparing to announce that he would. My local paper that morning carried the death notice for a beloved son, brother, father, uncle, best friend, a man just 32 years old who struggled for many years against his disease of addiction until God carried him to heaven. A jarring obituary verse that had suddenly become standard in a county where death by opioids was an epidemic. 3 miles away, a recently discharged 22-year-old Army vet was waking up in the same low-income housing project LeBron James used to call home, preparing for his daily hour-long walk to a downtown Akron community college, working to correct his life's course. A baby would be born that day at Mercy Medical Center, and a miniature orange Massillon Tigers football would be placed in his bassinet, a long-standing tradition in the town where American high school football began. 9 random people in Dayton were starting another morning with no reason to think the unthinkable. A nightclub horror of gunfire that awaited them 5 months hence. People got up. They dressed for work. They argued with their spouses. They urged their dogs to do their business. They fretted over bills on the desktop. They phoned in prescription refills. They asked what's for dinner tonight. Mrs. Gina Giffels, a teacher at St. Vincent de Paul Elementary, Akron, Ohio, entered the kitchen in her bathrobe, turned on the light, poured herself a coffee, and began her workday, arranging those cookies side by side in plastic containers. I helped. Not everybody in Ohio celebrates Statehood Day, but Mrs. Giffel's students sure do. In commemoration of the Buckeye State's 216th birthday, she would spirit those cookies into her classroom, breaking them out for the afternoon lesson. She would show her students how the dark blue icing along the edges designated the water borders. Lake Erie to the north, assuming one uses compass directions to navigate baked goods, and the Ohio River curving down the eastern and southern edges. She would tell them how important these waters have been to every part of life in Ohio, and she would point out the red dot of icing she'd put near the upper right, indicating their shared hometown. State history is a fourth-grade educational standard across the country. Students learn the story of their home place, the territory that designates them part of America, but that also gives them the beginning of a notion of their own unique version of Americanism. Ohio isn't any more American than any other place, but it is completely so. A unique cross-section that maps the persona of the nation in a way that has prompted others to turn here again and again to plumb our collective identity. In my lifetime here, it has been easy to believe, as novelist Dawn Powell once observed, that all Americans come from Ohio originally, if only briefly. It is an ur-place, sublimely average in both the dispositional and mathematical senses, an intersection of lifestyles and economies, of geographical characteristics and political tendencies, of climates, of conscience, of concerns, a place with answers to the most important question. Who are we? I was born in Akron and am a lifelong, doggedly committed citizen of a state that's often easier to leave than to love. I have spent much of my adult life thinking and writing about this place in widely ranging forms. For 18 years, I covered Northeast Ohio as a newspaper journalist. The books I've written all have Ohio themes and settings. I talk about it a lot, sometimes in bars, sometimes in classrooms, sometimes to outsiders looking to understand this place. I teach a course at the University of Akron on Ohio literature. My go-to beer is brewed in a district called Ohio City. I used to play in a band named after Cleveland's flagship department store, the May Company. Most important, my son and daughter, born and raised here, were just then coming into their own as adults, as citizens, as young people preparing to commit, each in their own way, to Ohio as their home and to a set of ideals that I still want to believe in. Gina left for school as the sun was coming up, and I completed my morning like I always do, reading the newspaper at the little table under the window, finishing what was left of the coffee, wishing there was a half cup more. I can't say that I was worried that morning in the way I might identify now. Like most people, I was occupied by the immediate concerns of the day, my classes to teach, an eye doctor's appointment, my expiring license plates. But I was worried, the way most people are, for my children, the son who was beginning police academy, the daughter leaving for class at the downtown university, still fretting over her path, asking me and Gina for an answer that we wished we had. What is my life going to be? I was worried, the way most people are, about the slim black smartphone at my side, the way it distracts and narrows my focus, the drag of social media, and the ways we no longer listen, and the ways we no longer speak. I was worried, the way most people were in 2019, about the chaos, division, and acrimony surrounding the presidency of Donald Trump. I was feeling that morning, like most people, the troubling misalignment of my country. And I was wondering about Ohio, a topic I wonder about perhaps more than any other. What I knew that morning and was beginning to consider in a newly urgent way is that I live in a very particular America, the America of Ohio, which has forever served uniquely as a reflection of the nation, a conscience of sorts. Even in a time when that reflection felt more like one from a funhouse mirror, I believed that in the far reaches of my territory, on farms and in little towns, in factories and in kitchens, there would be an answer to what that misalignment meant. So that's what I set off to find. The Ohio I was about to explore is such a remarkably reliable gauge of Americana that bellwether is our default political cliche, and test marketers beat a perennial path to our food courts. Pulitzer Prize-winning native son Lewis Bromfield observed nearly a century ago, in verbiage few other self-respecting Midwesterners would use, "Ohio is the apotheosis of Americanism." Geographically and culturally, the state is an all-American buffet, an uncannily complete everyplace. Cleveland is the end of the North. Cincinnati is the beginning of the South. Youngstown is the end of the East, and Hicksville, yes, Hicksville, is the beginning of the Midwest. Across 88 counties, Ohio mashes up broad regions of farmland, major industrial centers, small towns, the third largest university in the country, the second largest Amish population, and a bedraggled vein of Appalachia. It is coastal, it is rural, it is urban and suburban. Mainly because of the industrial age migration of Europeans, white Appalachians, and black Southerners to the cities for factory jobs, Ohio developed a rich cultural and political melting pot. The state's four distinct seasons, each intense unto itself, unfold like Currier and Ives.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.